Hello, today is February 27, 2010. Right now I'm modeling a sprint kayak, Olympic kayak, that has 5 meters 20 centimeters and beam is 41 centimeters. As you can see, I try to shape it in a way to make it as faster as possible to gain or to have the less drag on the water. So the hull is modeled in a way that you will get the best shape possible, and then to allow you, you know, to once this is submerged underwater, it will offer the less drag possible. I'm going to be explaining how I did this model later on. And right now I'm in the phase of getting the best shape possible. That is very close to what you are looking right here. So I first define the shape along the kayak from the stern to the bow, and you know, these shapes that are parabolic, most of them, will define that shape that I want to obtain as the final a hull shape of the kayak. That's very important to it. You're looking here the wireframe. I can, as I showed you before, just show the area or surface that are defining the shape of the kayak itself. This area is called the cockpit, where the person is seated or the paddler is seated, and the top of the kayak, as in any boat, is called the deck, and the bottom of it, the one that is in contact with the water, is called the hull. After some work, I finally got the shape that I want, and I'm going to start defining or making some final details to it. I originally wanted to make a structural analysis, an FEA analysis, finite element analysis to it, but right now I'm going to be more focused on the shape of the hull in order to obtain the best shape possible, and in order to do that I'm going to run a CFD, computational fluid dynamics analysis, and that will allow me to see how's the shape, I mean, under some conditions of waves, or once the kayak is submerged, depending on the weight on it, it will you know, behave different. Also the influence of the water or the waves coming from the side or at an angle. I may also introduce some effect of the wind, if any. Normally these kayaks are used on very steady waters, flat waters. That's the reason they are also called flat waters kayaks. But the intention of this kayak is, once I define it, is to be able to build it. I'm going to try to build it using composites, and I will show you that process later on. I hope to start building this kayak in the next weeks, so. Yeah, come back and see if I what I've been done, or what's the progress of the work. Goodbye.